Good morning. We want to welcome you to our usual science demonstration, but this morning it's a math demonstration. And I thought, since some of us love to do math, who might be listening would enjoy a math demonstration. So please open the slideshow entitled Turning Circles into Squares. Did you know you could do that, Ashley? I didn't know it either, but we're going to see it happen this morning in our math demonstration. Slide 2, we're basing this on Matthew 19:26, which says, "But Jesus beheld them and said unto them, With men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible." And that's what you will see happening. That's one of the reasons I like science so much. And especially today, we're going to enjoy math and see some things which we might think would be impossible. Next slide. The materials you need for this particular demonstration are simple. Some strips of paper, maybe 1.5 inches wide, 10 inches long, a pencil, some sticky tape, scissors, and a marker is about all you need for this demonstration. And it's all based on something the next slide is about. August F. Mobius. Now, he's not the only one. There was another one who discovered the Mobius strip, so to speak, about the same time, but it's named after him, August F. Mobius. The first thing I want to, and I'm going to need Ashley here with me to help. Now, Ashley, if we took this strip of paper and made a circle out of it and taped it, could you get a piece of tape and tape it for me, please? Thank you very much. And now we have a loop. And if we cut that loop in half, what would happen?
Two loops.
You think we would have two loops? I'm going to ask you, we need to move down a little ways. I'm going to ask you to snip right there and then to start cutting around and see. And she says we're going to have two loops. And even though some of us may not be a favorite of math, but yes, she's right. If you take something and cut it in half, you're going to get two. And that's exactly what she's doing here. She's gotten two loops now. Now, if we took a strip of paper and instead of making a loop, we did a half twist to it, like that, and I've already done it here for you. And, well, let's just use this one, but if you want to twist it.
Is it?
I think so, yes. So we have to stick it. And now it's the same length of paper, same piece of paper. If we cut it in half, would we get two? And
I think you'll get two together.
Well, let's try it. I'm going to, you go ahead, cut it around like you did the other piece of paper. And it's the same strip of paper, just with a half twist to it. And let's see what happens if we cut this one in half. Instead of two separate pieces, we get just a larger loop. And it still has a twist in it. See? So it didn't come out as two different pieces. Now I have another question for you, Ashley. I have here what I made is an X or a plus sign. And you could draw this on a piece of paper. But I did it a quick way with two strips and just and made a plus sign. And what we want to do now, of course, we can consider that there is a north and a south, and an east and a west. And so what we want to do, Ashley, join the north and south ends together without any twist. The slide number is 12. We'll go back to the slides we've missed in just a minute. Now, for the east-west strip, you are to join them with a half twist. In other words, make a Mobius strip out of them.
Like so?
Mm-hmm. Okay. And see, I've done that ahead of time for you. And hers looks just like mine. The one loop without a twist and the other loop with a twist. Now we want to take the east-west strip that has the loop in it. And we want to cut, wait, don't start cutting. We want to cut twice in this. So the first time you cut, stay kind of close to an edge, okay? And then we're going to go around one more time so that we've cut it twice. And you just keep on going through. Not too close to the edge. We don't want anything to tear.
It's on the opposite side.
Well, let me try it with mine. Let's see. Cutting around and around and around.
And you switch sides.
And around. Well, I'm just going to keep cutting. Until we get back to where we started. I'm not sure that...
This is supposed to happen. Just do this at home.
Well, now let's just wait a minute here. We're going to, excuse me just for a moment, and check the book. Well, this is the one I was going to say you should try at home. Because the important one is, we're going to come back to this in just a minute, but the important one that I wanted to show Ashley, I thought it was that one. Have you ever made a paper chain?
Yes.
Okay, so what I want you to do, Ashley...
Make a paper chain.
Right. When we make the second chain, like this, go ahead and put it together. We also have to make this solid. So we have to tape where we have our chain. It's loose now, but I want it solid here. So we're going to tape it inside. And it might take another piece of tape. It's a little crooked, but I think it might work.
Do you want me to redo it so it's straight?
Yes, let's pull this off to make sure we lay it in there straight. There you go. And I think I would like another piece of tape under here to make sure, because we're going to be cutting this and we don't want it to come off. There you go. I'm on slide 14. Make two strips with no twists, but connect them as you would a paper chain, taping or gluing the two chains together in the middle so they are not loose, like this. It's a paper chain. Now, we want to cut one loop in half. I'll get it started, and you can just continue cutting if you want. Just keep cutting. Cut that loop in half. Now, what we have, if you can see, is two loops and a straight piece of paper. Next step is to cut that straight piece of paper in half. What do we have, Ashley?
A square.
Can you believe that? We started with two circles, and now we have a square. That's fun. Don't you like? You want to do that again? Let's try it with two small pieces of paper, and that square will be a little smaller that maybe we can get it all into the... So what do you do? Do you remember how to do this? Okay, she's going to do that experiment again, and while she's doing that, I want to back up on some of these slides. Let's go back up to slide 5. When you make a Mobius strip, when you take a piece of paper and give it a half twist to make a Mobius strip, you are creating something that... let's go to the next slide. Has only one side. You go all the way around, and you'll find out if you were an ant, so to speak. If you will look at slide 7, this Mobius strip has only one side and one edge. Think of an ant crawling around the inside of an ordinary band of loop of paper. If an ant were crawling around on the inside, it would just stay inside. If it wanted to get to the outside, it would have to crawl over the edge and crawl around the outside. But that's not true with a Mobius strip, because the ant could just keep walking in a straight line and cover the whole strip. It wouldn't have to cross over an edge. He would be able to walk in a straight line and cover both sides of the strip. Slide 8. You can see that. Isn't that neat, Ashley? That's just one of the things you can do with paper. And it's all the same amount of paper. It started out with circles and you end up with a square simply by twisting and cutting. Now, where is our Mobius strip? Do we have a Mobius strip here that we haven't cut?
I was going to use it.
So okay, you can have it. All right. Now, to prove that it has only one edge, you could take a marker and just go around without lifting your marker, and you would mark. And you want to give it a try? Let's see. We'll start on this edge, and we will just... You want to do it, Ashley? Just
yes.
Mark the edge, and you
Why
will
not?
See...
Do you want to do it?
No, we have. What we're doing is making sure there's only one edge to this Mobius strip, even though the paper itself, when you loop it, has two edges. But by giving it a half twist, it changes the topography of that piece of paper, and we're going to talk about. Can you do it? And next slide, slide 9, if we were to cut this strip in half, which we've already done, we wouldn't get two strips, but just a larger strip. Now, Mobius strips are often used in machinery belts, because if you make a belt to run a piece of equipment, and it runs and runs on one side, it might wear out faster. So the belt is made into a Mobius strip, so it gets even wear on both inside and outside.
It worked? It went all the way up.
Very good, Ashley. Okay. This useful strip, this Mobius strip, is part of a branch of mathematics called topology. Topology can be hard to explain because in it, straight lines and edges aren't important. And a circle is considered to be the same as a square. And we saw that in this little demonstration. Take another strip of paper and twist it in a full twist. Ashley, if we, instead of doing a half twist, do a full twist, you could try cutting that in half and see what happens. Ashley wants to try it now. You could try doing it with another half twist and see what happens. You can take another strip of paper, make a full twist in it before taping the ends together. Now you cut it into two strips. Remember, topology is changing the shape. Now the reason I'm telling you all this, there is a spiritual lesson that we're getting to. Some people feel they could never become a Christian. It's like trying to put a square into a round hole. They'll never be a Christian. They just don't fit. Maybe you've heard that. With God, all things are possible. He is the master of topology. And here's a picture in slide 16 of a square and a round shape. With him, there are no boundaries, no limitations of space or shape. And that reminds me of a verse in Galatians 3:28 says, there is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither bond nor free, there is neither male nor female, for ye are all one in Christ. And so it doesn't matter what shape we have. If we're circles with twists or full twists.
This is the full twist.
This is the full twist one. This is what happens when you cut it in half. You get two loops still connected. It doesn't matter.
That's after it's been cut in half the first time.
Right. You take one strip of paper and make a full twist and then cut it in half and you get two separate loops that are still connected. But the lesson that we want to learn from this is God is the master of mathematics even, of topology, of shapes. Our boundaries are not boundaries to him. You may think, I'll never be like Christ. It's like fitting a square into a round hole. But he can do that. That's the miracle of what God does in our hearts. He changes us into Christians, into having the mind of Christ. So it doesn't matter if you're squares, circles, triangles, if you are big, tall, small, whatever. God can work in your heart the same as he works in everyone's hearts and changes them into what he would like. And here, Ashley, what have you done with your strips?
This was the plus sign one that we did earlier that didn't work.
Do you think it worked now?
I don't know.
I don't know what we were supposed to do.
We discussed parts doing one cut.
Okay, we're going to keep working on the east, west, north, south one. But until we meet again, may God richly bless you. And have a wonderful Sabbath. Bye-bye.